मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड हेल्दी एट योर होम एंड आई वेलकम अगेन टू इंग्लिश ऑनलाइन क्लास. सो आई होप यू हैव डन योर होमवर्क प्रॉपरली एंड प्लीज सबमिट द होल डेज होमवर्क टाइम. अप टू नाउ वी हैव डन टू लेसन्स ऑफ द रीडर एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट our home one, that is the field mouse. So please open your reader book at page number 37. Please take out your book and open it at page number 37. Have you opened? Okay. So the name of the poem is the field mouse. And what is the name of the poet? That is Cecil Francis Alexander. What is the name? Cecil Francis Alexander. Today we are going to read this poem. Dear students, whenever you read any poem or any lesson, always try to learn the name of the poet or the writer. In exams, question can be framed on the basis of this writer and the poet. So always try to learn or always learn the name of the writer and the poet. So this is poem The Field Mouse and the name of the poet is Cecil Francis Alexander. So let's start our reading. Page number 37. Okay, start. Where the acorn tumbles down, where the ash tree sheds its fell. With your fur so soft and brown, with your eye so round and merry, scarcely moving the long grass, field mouse, I can see you pass, I can see you pass. So this is the poem about the field mouse. Mouse you know very well, but the poet is talking about the field mouse, the mouse that lives in the field. So what does the poet say in the first stanza? Where the acorn tumbles down. What do you mean by acorn? Acorn is the fruit of the oak tree. It is not the fruit of any tree, but only the oak fruit is known as acorn. And whenever it tumbles down means rolls down, niche. So we can see the field mouse there. Where the ash tree sheds its bell. And whenever ash tree sheds its berry, whenever the fruits of the ash tree comes down, and we can see the field mouse there. With your fur so soft and brown. See, here in the third line, the poet is describing the mouse, that how the mouse appears. The mouse fur is so soft and the color is brown. With your eyes so round and merry. And how the eyes are described? Eyes are round and merry. Merry means full of happiness. Round, you know very well, circle. Next line, scarcely moving the long grass, field mouse, I can see you pass, I can see you pass. Scarcely moving, scarcely means rarely, very less, sometime only. Moving the long grass, field mouse, the poet is saying that I can see you pass, I can see you in the field only, very less you are coming in the long grass. So in the first stanza we can learn, we can see that the poet is telling that what the mouse is like. Mouse is soft and mouse fur is soft and the color is brown and the eyes are round and merry. So this is the appearance of the mouse. So next stanza, little thing in what dark den lie you all the winter sleeping. In second stanza, the poet is asking a question to the field mouse that what do you do in the winter season? Do you sleep the whole winter season? The poet is asking the question to the field mouse. Yes, during the winter season, the field mouse sleeps. Okay? Till warm weather comes again, and whenever the warm weather comes again after the winter, we can observe spring. After the winter, spring season comes. Then in the spring season, again the field mouse comes in the ground. And then once again, we can see the mouse peeping through its hole. Means peeping means झाल वो देख सकता है to look outward little. Round about the tall tree roots, nibbling at their fallen fruits. What do we mean by these lines? Round about the tall tree roots. You can see here both the trees there. Means it is tall tree, and these are the roots here. So we can see the field mouse roaming here. And what does the mouse do? The mouse nibbles at the fruits which are fallen down the tree. जो फील्ड माउस है वो फ्रूट्स को खाता है जो कि हमारे ट्री के नीचे होते हैं. Nibbles means to eat with small bites. Okay? थोड़ा थोड़ा कुतर कर खाना, that is known as nibbling. Next third stanza. Field mouse do not know where the farmer stacks his treasure. Now the poet is saying to the field mouse that do not go. Where the poet is saying the mouse not to go? The poet is saying the mouse not to go to the crops which the farmer has gathered. Jo farmer ne crops gather kare. What do you mean by here? His treasure. What is the treasure? Who is his here? He is referring to the farmer. Jo farmer ne treasure. What is the treasure for the farmer? His grain. His crops is the treasure for the farmer. So the poet is requesting to the field mouse not to go to the crops of the farmer which the farmer has collected with much hard work. Find the nut that falls below, eat the acorn at your pleasure. And the poet is requesting to the field mouse not to eat the crop, just to eat the nuts which are fallen down the tree. And he can and the mouse can eat the acorn also with ease. Aram se unko nuts ko ya acorns ko kha sakta hai, but not to eat the crops of the farm. Next line. But you must not steal the grain he has stacked with so much pain. So the poet is saying that not to steal the grain. Steal means to take something illegally. Means the poet is requesting the field mouse not to steal the grain. जो उसने grain, जो उसकी crops है, जो उसका फसल है, उसे नहीं चुराना है. He has stacked with so much pain. क्यों? Because the farmer has gathered that crop with so much pain. What do you mean by here? Much pain. Much pain means it is collected with much hard work. So it is not a good thing if the mouse will take the crop. So up to third stanza we have read. Now move to next fourth one. Make your hole where mosses spring underneath the tall oak's shadow. What does the poet say? The poet is saying that make your hole where mosses spring. Whenever spring comes, the soil becomes wet. So the poet is saying to the field mouse to make the hole under the tree only, not to go to the house or to the crops of the farmer. Pretty quite harmless thing, play about the sunny meadow. Means the poet is saying that the field mouse can play in the sunny meadow. Meadow means a field, a large large land, you can see large land of grass. Keep away from cone and house, none will harm you little mouse. In the last two lines the poet is assuring the field mouse that nobody will harm you if you will keep yourself away from corn and house of the farmer. So I hope it is clear to you. You can see the rhymes here, rhyming words you can see like down, brown, berry, merry, grass, fast. So these all are rhyming words here. And if we talk about the summary of the field mouse, you can see that the poet is telling that the how the field mouse eat, telling about the field mouse eating habits, where does the field mouse live. Okay, so in the picture also you can see that the mice are there down the tree. So I hope it is understood. So dear students, I hope you have understood the poem. Now let's have a look on the summary of the poem. So in the first stanza we can see that the poet is telling the eating habits of the field mouse. What does he eat? He eats the acorn and the berries which are fallen down the tree. And in the third and fourth line, the poet is telling the appearance of the mouse, that the mouse has soft fur and brown in color, and the eyes are rounded, merry, and we can see the mouse in the field. And in the next stanza, the poet is prohibiting the mouse not to go to the field, not to go to the crops of the farmer. He is asking a question to the field mouse, that what do you do in the winter season? In winter season, the field mouse takes a long sleep, and the after winter, in spring season, the field mouse comes back when the weather has, now weather is warm, okay, and he started nibbling the fallen fruits which are fallen down the tree. And in the next time, in the next stanza, the poet is requesting the mouse not to eat the grain of the crops, not to go to the crops which is collected by the farmer with much hard work. He can eat the nuts, he can eat the apples which are fallen down the tree, and requesting him not to steal the grain of the farmer. And how the grain is collected, how the crops are collected, means it is collected with much hard work. Whenever a farmer works in the field, it requires much hard work. So that's why it is written here with so much pain. And in the last stanza, the poet is saying to the field mouse that make your hole only under the tree, not to, he requesting him not to make the hole in the house of the farmer or the corn crops of the farmer. So I hope it is clear to you. In next video, we will revise the word.